I suppose they've got another suit back there, do you? That one looks a bit tight for me.
And you would look a right tit in it.
Evie.
Seems a letter has come for Jacob.
Why, that's a lovely cane.
The cane gives you an...
Thank you.
I would like a 7-inch flywheel, please.
Hang on. In a minute. Damn it.
Miss Evie! I done something dreadful! The train won't stop!
Keep your flywheel.
Think about the future.
Check on the driver.
Thank you.
Seems a letter has come for Jacob.
A letter?
You should see what's waiting for you at Whitechapel Station. Nigel wants to make up for things, so he got you a gift.
Mr. Frye, come have a look at this. Ain't she a beauty?
Oh, well done, Nigel.
Yeah, I nicked it off the gang across town, got them all stewed, and then took it when they was asleep. Here, sir, let me show you. It's jammed. Oh, shit. Move!
I believe it's time to go!
A letter? For me?
We haven't tuppence in the coffers.
Another exciting night home for Evie Frye.
Just on my way out, actually. I found the Peace of Eden.
What's this one going to do, hmm? Heal the sick? Deflect bullets? Control the populace?
They're dangerous objects, Jacob, especially in Templar hands.
Oh, you sound exactly like Father.
If only. Lucy Thorne is expecting a shipment tonight. She's Starek's expert in the occult. I'm nearly certain she is receiving the Peace of Eden Sir David Brewster mentioned.
Sounds like fun. Mind if I join you?
Promise you will stick to the mission.
I swear.
The contents of that box are worth more than your life, and those of your entire family. Do you understand?
Yes, Miss Thorne.
Careful there! And double the guard on that cart!
Now, Miss Thorne, there's the matter of some papers for Mr. Starek. If you'll just come this way.
Very well, but make it quick.
Whatever it is she's after, it's in that chest.
There are gunmen on the rooftops.
Can you dispose of them before I reach the cart?
I was hoping for a challenge.
Actually.
There he is!
I think it's best we leave.
What did you do?
It's hardly the time for questions!
Whoa! Come on!
What are we supposed to do with papers?
Read them! If only we had the time!
Doing fine, girl.
Movement! Research!
Keep moving.
My sister was a lot of things! Easy. Come over here and get it!
Well, that was fun. Thanks for the invitation.
Let's do it again.
Damn it.
The train for you. Lack of paint, new rugs from Camden Loch, and my wee sister, the seamstress, did a discount on the curtains.
Seems a letter has come for Jacob.
Sister, sometimes you exasperate me.
You may have not found a piece of Eden, but this material is invaluable. Look. It says the London assassins had found a shroud.
The Shroud of Eden is supposed to heal even the gravest injury. If the assassins had found something like this, surely Father would have known.
There must be something we're missing.
Something only we can see. These look like directions. Are you coming?
Fieldwork is not really my speciality.
We found a clue to a precursor object. Don't you want to follow it?
Put that way, one can hardly refuse. Do you know, I think this map may be taking us to the Kenway mansion.
Kenway? The pirate?
The master assassin and pirate, yes.
How much do you know about the Shroud of Eden?
It's said to heal the sick. Popular myth is that it brings people back from the dead, but the assassin records say that's not true. I've never heard of one being in London. Do you really think Edward Kenway could have found one?
He traveled extensively, so it's possible. But if he did, he kept it a closely guarded secret.
But if it's true, what a find it would be.
Indeed. I'm eager to find out myself. It's surprising that you haven't already searched the Kenway house.
Edward's son, Haven, joined the Templars. When he died, the house passed on to Haven's sister.
And in all your time in London, you didn't go and have a look around? I think this is it.
I think you're right. Look.
I'll be in the study. I don't want to be interrupted unless you have news of the lost notebook.
That makes getting in a challenge.
You still intend to enter?
If this is a Templar stronghold, it won't get any easier. Don't worry. We'll stay well away from Miss Lucy. Shall we? That's all anyone can do. Can you check over there?
Of course.
Excellent choice. Hope to see you again.
The language of flowers.
Jason!
Another assassin artifact.
If this keeps up, I'm gonna tell her I'm not patrolling anymore.
Be my guest, but that won't end well for you.
This should belong to the assassins.
What are we looking for?
I'm not quite sure.
What are the Templars not seeing?
Something only we can.
Where would a pirate hide his treasure?
I'd hide mine in a library.
Subtle, is it?
Clearly, Kenway had a strong sense of spectacle. The history of the London assassins. Bolt holes, vaults, a hidden key. This is it.
You say you heard music. There was no opening there before. It's closing! Yes, I can see that. Help me block it!
We need to find another way out. An entire vault, filled with assassin history, left behind once again.
We'll just have to reclaim this one later, or find a better cache.
We? I thought you preferred to stay out of fieldwork.
I was thinking more of you and your brother. I shall provide planning assistance from the train.
Jacob's off.
Mr. Frye, I trust that you had a productive meeting with Mr. Owen?
Oh, yes. We had the most wonderful chat. I found out the man behind Starek's soothing syrup is John Elliotson.
Dr. Elliotson? I haven't heard that name in a long while. He was a brilliant heart specialist until he became obsessed with phrenology and mesmerism. It ruined his career. Well, how shall we proceed?
Oh, with all respect, Mr. Darwin, I believe I should proceed alone. After all, we wouldn't want to attract any unwanted attention.
Sounds very wise. Good luck, my boy. Oh, and Mr. Frye, should you find yourself with any free time, please do call on me.
Where would I find the doctor?
Just witnessed, the application of too much pressure can sometimes result in unexpected outcomes. Unfortunately, it appears I've ruined the organ. Send up a cadaver.
At once, Dr. Elliotson.
I don't care about your ethics. and I care even less about your damn patience. Now hand over your keys.
What are you doing?
Haven't you heard? You're fired. Now bugger off.
How to do it.
What's the matter?
Oh, young man, help. I must speak with Miss Nightingale at once. One of the brutes stole my key and there's no one around. I can't get out of here.
Stole your key? Don't go anywhere. I might be able to do something.
Oh, quite. Thank you, sir. Well, you'll know where to find me, sir. Oh, go on now, sir. I will wait here.
use of the soothing serum. Despite the specimen's violent reaction to the procedure, the soothing syrup anesthetized its senses and it died without suffering. What you have just witnessed is nothing less than the undeniable effectiveness of the medicine of tomorrow.
Watch him out!
All the children need to be taught a lesson. No spinning in the schoolyard.
The science behind it teaches us how to not only identify, but also how to measure the mental performance of the patient. For instance, this specimen's overdeveloped organs found on either side of the lower back of its head. The protuberance is...
Grandmaster Sterling warned him about new assassins.
I'll do anything you want.
The presence in London has not gone unnoticed.
At last it ends. Yet I can only think of beginnings. A better tomorrow. Forged with the blood of visionaries.
All I see is the blood of a lunatic.
You truly believe murdering an old man will stop humanity's great architect? Crawford Starrick has a glorious design for mankind.
Designs are meant to be broken.
You're a child. A child who believes it can solve all the world's woes with a flick of a blade. Have you ever pondered the consequences of your actions, Jacob Frye? Or did your father teach you nothing?
Thank you.
Elliotson expired, and soothing syrup production has ceased. Outrageous!
Frye intends to endanger all of London at the hands of the mob.
Or perhaps he doesn't intend much of anything at all.
Thank you.
Simply content to dice with our lives.
The asylum is shut up. Medical care throughout the city is in disarray. He does not, cannot understand the consequences of his actions. The man is clearly an anarchist!
Gentlemen. This tea was brought to me from India, by a ship, then up from the harbor to a factory, where it was packaged and ferried by carriage to my door, unpacked in the larder and brought upstairs to me. All by men and women who work for me, who are indebted to me, Crawford Starrick, for their jobs, the time, the very lives they lead. They will work in my factories, and so too shall their children. And you come to me with talk of this Jacob Frye. This insignificant blemish who calls himself assassin? You disrespect the very city that works day and night so that we may drink this. This miracle, this tea.
I'm nearing the end of my research. Our beloved London shall not suffer such a bothersome fool for much longer.
And what of this sister I've heard of? Miss Frye.
Miss Frye shall be gutted. Soon enough. Delicious.
Sorry to interrupt, Initiate. Thought you'd like to know that Sean and Rebecca got away from Otzoberg. Berg runs a unit called Sigma Team. Violet DaCosta is his tech support. They've been hunting and killing assassins for a long time. Thank God you're all right.
Oh, tish tosh. It'll take more than a Templar super soldier to end the glorious saga of Sean Danger Hastings.
I was talking to Rebecca.
Right. Anyway, Berg's presence confirms it. The Peace of Eden is in London.
The Initiate's data sync suggests it's the Shroud.
The Templars seem to want it pretty bad all of a sudden. They must know something we don't.
The only thing we know is that we can't go up against Sigma Team alone.
Leave that to me. In the meantime, keep a low profile. Let the Initiate continue to sync the data.
A letter? For me?
Owning the railway wasn't enough. Now Starrick has bought an omnibus company as well. I suppose he wants to control the neighborhood's workers and keep them under his thumb.
Pearl Attaway is Starrick's competitor, is she? Perhaps it's time I went into business.
And Miss Frye, what are your plans?
I studied the history we recovered from the Kenway Mansion's hidden room. I'm off to a certain monument.
A letter? For me?
Choice. Hope to see you again. Leaving empty-handed? Pity.
Shall we trade off for a bit?
What the hell is that?
What's that then?
Indeed, a crime against humanity. I demand you live up to your responsibilities.
Listen to me. I have been ordered to keep your rallies off the streets.
No, you must listen to me. The people in this city are in dire need of your assistance. Oh, you are Jacob Frye, are you not? And Miss Frye?
We're at a disadvantage, sir.
Karl Marx, much like you, I am an activist of sorts.
You've got the look of a man who wants something.
Indeed. You've done more for London's citizens lately than any endeavor has accomplished in a decade. But those citizens were already well provided for. I challenge you both to help those who really need your assistance, the working people.
An interesting challenge. We accept.
Shouldn't we at least talk about these things for... Sod it. We accept.
I'm organizing a discreet meeting with some like-minded friends to discuss trades unions. Alas, the police seem to have noticed my activities. They've stuck to me like flies on Scheiser. In any case, I need you to help me get to the meeting without the interference of the police. You see? There's one of their damn spies now.
Not you down!
tonight, sundown, the usual place.
I'll be there.
You know, I had similar problems with the police in Paris. Well, Paris and Brussels. And also, perhaps Cologne. Our next worthy ally awaits us in a nearby pub. Onwards. No doubt the police already have agents stationed within. I'll wait here until the coast is clear.
Are you well?
I'm your man.
I'll back you up. You
stop right bloody now!
I could use a hand. Take care of this.
Let's build repairs!
On your
own! I'll break your
stick. I've asked the one to take you out.
Deal with them!
To me dogs.
Nothing here for you, but man!
I'll rip your tongue for that! You won't be stirring up no more trouble.
She's tiring!
Thank you, you can go.
I'm with ya!
The usual location. 1 hour.
Right you are, Mr. Marks, sir.
I believe our work here is complete. Come, let's slip away and get to the meeting. I do appreciate your assistance in this matter. Only when workers are able to assemble freely and in strength will we be able to achieve the reforms we most assuredly deserve. Might I trouble you to stay nearby until the meeting is over? I fear we may yet meet with some mischief. It seems the movement is ever doomed to be betrayed from within. Will you fetch the gentleman back here? I would look him in the eye and ask why he went back on his brethren.
Mistake.
No noise, just walk.
Looks like
I'll do it all come of that. You mark my words.
In God's name, help!
Wonder what's all that about? What is the commotion?
What's going on over there?
Simon, my friend, what possessed you to do this thing? Has the party not taken care of you?
Governor of the Millsea, any man what joins a union will be put out of work come sun up. How long will the party feed my family for?
If we do not stand together, we are lost. My heart is broken, Simon. Please go. I thank you, my friend. I hope you will continue to aid the struggle when the opportunity presents itself.
Miss Attaway.
Yes, may I? Oh. Splendid. You're here to murder me.
I what?
No matter. Everyone has a price. Is this enough?
I'm not here to kill you.
And what's your game?
Mr. Starrick and the Milner Company have blocked your ambitions long enough. I have a business proposition for you.
Wonderful. Come with me. We have much to discuss, Mr.
Jacob Frye. At your service.
Truer words were never spoken.
If you'd be so kind as to take the reins. You must understand, I've received threats against my life. Malcolm Miller has all but waged war on me since Mr. Starrick brought out his people. And no offense, I hope, but you do look the cure.
I doubt I shall ever recover from such a slight.
What then is your interest in my redemption, Mr. Frye?
I sense an opportunity that would benefit us both.
Do you?
Is that so hard to believe?
Whatever your intentions, it will be quite the time to strike back against Milner and Starrick. I have worked like a troop to make a gateway transport. That's one of Milner's.
Doing fine, girl.
Yeah.
Steady on.
Malcolm Milner. Starek's puppet himself.
Careful, you twats! This park scene needs to make it to the Outway Depot.
He thinks he can burn my buses. Let's give him a taste of his own medicine.
Let's give him the whole damn bottle. We'll turn Milner's park scene against him. But I'll need help from my gang.
Such entrepreneurial instinct, Mr. Frye. I shall leave you to it.
You could see that smoke from across the bloody river.
Setting our buses on fire. It never gets old.
Serves our way right for thinking she has the right to compete with us.
Heave-ho, Jacob. Primed and ready.
Plummeting already. You're hired. Oh, I have more business planned for us both. Drop a note to my secretary to make an appointment, and I shall reveal the next step in our scheme.
I don't actually work. Like that.
Shaky.
Mr. Frye. I told you to make an appointment.
My schedule was open.
You're fortunate I like you.
Internal combustion engines.
Eight small syllables that mean a great deal of money. The engines will be delivered to Milner by train. Secure them for me, and he will be devastated.
I'll need a second train to pull this off. And I think I know just the man.
So we have a deal, Mr. Frye?
You're fortunate I like you, Miss Attaway. How are you today? Show him how it's done.
Ah!
To collect you.
No, it's too late now. Just get us out of here. So, what do you want, Frye?
What makes you so sure I want something? Perhaps I saved you out of the kindness of my own heart. Come on, let me tell you about the job.
Miller's pulling a lot of cargo there.
Just be sure to make the transfer.
Give him hell.